What up, everybody? CPA Strength here, strongest CPA in the state of Florida. I don't even think anybody's messing with me on that anymore. I don't even know. I might have to go to the Southeast region. Who knows? But anyways, this is the classic series, man. You're back again. You love it. I love teaching. I love doing it. This is awesome. Let's go. Accounting for Beginners, number 26, the classic series. What do you got to say about that? Are we having fun yet? Let's go. Okay. Does this transaction increase assets? I don't know. This is our third one in a row. Does the transaction increase assets? But of course, we're going to make our journal entry first and then see what it does, what the do's, what it is, what it does. Yeah. I just squat PR today. 315, 5 sets of 10 reps, 50 reps, beltless. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I got that dopamine rush. Let's go back just a little bit to Accounting for Beginners 25. I know you just came from there anyways, thank you very much. Accounting for Beginners 25, we did a service and they said, hey bro, we're gonna pay you later. So basically you fronted your workout in 25. Someone owes you money, that was an accounts receivable. The transaction for AFB 26 is receive cash as payment from customer account for $2,000. So thank God the mug finally paid up. So we finally paid the $2,000. We're gonna make our journal entry, of course, and then we're going to see if the assets went up and answer the question. Thank you very much. Oh, yo, we're having some big time. I just bumped that. I don't know where I was. So we're just gonna go into the question here. I know that you already have DC Adler written on your paper. Debit, credit, asset, draw, expense, liability, equity, revenue. I already know you have that on your paper. Thank you very much. We have DC Adler written down. What's next? Let's write a journal entry for the transaction. Received cash as payment from customer on account for $2,000. Do we have cash? Yes, we have cash. Bing, 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 bing. We're gonna get half the journal entry correct. Received cash. Received. So I'm getting cash. Cash is in a positive form. We know that that's going to be our debit because the DC Adler is in the positive forms here. So just look, receive cash. Getting cash, getting money. We know cash is an asset. We received it, so it's going up, so that's going to be our debit. Cash is our debit. How much cash did we get? As payment from customer on account for $2,000. We got $2,000. That's our debit. Cash $2,000. Received cash as payment from customer. Okay, so there's half of it. Now we've already got this done. On account for $2,000. So now he paid it to me, so that means he owed me the money. If he owed me the money, it was an account receivable. So on account receivable. Let's just say that's all that was on the accounts receivable was $2,000. So someone owed us $2,000. They paid us the $2,000. So that means what is owed to us is nothing. So our account receivable went down $2,000. We know from before that account receivable is an asset because it's like in place of cash, and cash is our asset. We love cash. So we know that it's an asset. We know that accounts receivable is an asset. And it went down because they paid us what they owed us, the $2,000. So if an asset is negative, that's a credit. All right. So if an asset's a negative, it's a credit. So we're gonna credit accounts receivable. For how much? For $2,000. It went down for $2,000. All right, look, so this is our journal entry. Debit cash 2,000, Credit, accounts receivable 2,000. Cash is an asset. It's a debit, so that means the asset is going up. Accounts receivable for 2,000 is our credit. Accounts receivable is an asset. And since accounts receivable is an asset on the credit side, that means it is going down. Debit, cash, asset going up. Credit, accounts receivable, asset going down. Up, down. Up, up, down. That's kind of how I see it. It's like a whew. Anywho, does this work? Receive cash as payment from customer on account for $2,000. Receive cash $2,000. So that means cash going up. Debit it. Boom. From customer on account. On account. Let's see. So he paid me. So the account that it must have been accounts receivable because he paid me. If it was an accounts payable, I would have paid him. So it must have been accounts receivable. Great. So accounts receivable, we already have our debit, so we need a credit. Accounts receivable is our credit. We got $2,000, so it must have lessened what he owed us, right? So the accounts receivable account must go down. That means it's going to be a credit. And of course, the amounts equal 2,000 equals 2,000. Boom, check done. Bing! Okay. Now, this is kind of where it gets tricky. So we have our journal entry. So let's answer the question. Does the transaction increase assets? Does it? Why don't you think about it for 1 second? Hit pause. Let's see, does it increase? We have a $2,000 asset going up, and then we have a $2,000 asset going down. So, no, they're the same. So it does not, no, does not increase assets, they're the same. Thank you very much for watching this. If you liked it, please subscribe for more, because I'm doing lots of these accounting for beginners. I'm gonna become the accounting man on the YouTube. What up with it? Peace.
Cauliflower and broccoli pizza. Frank's Red Hot.
With this.
Or Crystal.
But it's